हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर फर्स्ट क्लास दैट इज इन न्यूमरिकल सॉल्यूशन, एनएसएम न्यूमरिकल एंड स्टैटिस्टिकल मेथड. सो ऑलरेडी आई हैव सेड आई विल टेक द फर्स्ट थ्री यूनिट्स इन दिस पेपर दैट इज न्यूमरिकल एंड लास्ट टू यूनिट्स आई विल टेक. एंड इन आई हैव सेंड वन वीडियो ऑल्सो डिपेंड ऑन द हाउ टू ऑपरेट द कैलकुलेटर, साइंटिफिक कैलकुलेटर. ओके, सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद माई यूनिट टू. That is numerical solution of non-linear equation. Okay, so in this class we will see the basic things: what is algebraic equation, what is transcendental equation, and what is bisection method. Then in the next class onwards we will solve the problems. Okay, so please be prepared with your calculator, and whatever I will solve the problem here, please try that problem on your home and check whether you are getting the same answer or not. Okay, try to practice the how to operate the calculator. So I will start with algebraic and transcendental equation. First we will see what is algebraic equation. So equation which involving algebraic quantities, the equation which involving algebraic quantities like x, x square, x cube, x raised to 4 and so on. Suppose if your equation involving these quantities, that is x, x square, x cube, x raised to 4, then that type of equation is called algebraic equation. That type of equation is called algebraic equation. Or it can be 2x or 3x square or minus x cube or 4x raised to 4, like this. Okay. Suppose in your equation, if these terms are coming, x, x square, x cube, x raised to 4, then that equation is called algebraic equation. For example, you can take 2x square minus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. See here, we are having here x square term and x term. So here algebraic quantity is involving x square and x. Therefore, this equation is called algebraic equation. Or we can write x cube minus 2x, 2x square plus x plus 5 is equal to 0. See, this equation is also called algebraic equation because here the algebraic terms or algebraic quantities involving x cube, x square, x, 5. See here, coefficient be any number, okay, because this is the constant. Either it is 2 or it is positive or negative. But suppose if your equation involving these terms, x, x square, x cube, x raised to 4 and so on, then that type of equation is called algebraic equation, okay. Because in this numerical solution, we have to find the solution of algebraic and transcendental equation only. Okay. Next, what is mean by transcendental equation? Suppose in your equation, the terms or if it involving trigonometric function, if it involving trigonometric function, logarithmic function, function, and exponential function, if your equation involving these three functions, then that equation is called transcendental equation. You know what is trigonometry function. Trigonometry function is sin x or cos x, tan x, cot x. You studied this, tan x, cot x, cosec x, sec x. If it, that is nothing but trigonometric function. Logarithmic function means log x. And exponential function means e to the power of x. Suppose if your equation involving these three functions, that is either it can involve in trigonometric or logarithmic or exponential, then that equation is called transcendental equation. For example, suppose if you are having x into sin x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now see, in this equation we are having trigonometric function, that is sin x. Therefore, this equation is called transcendental equation. Or let us take the second example. X plus log x plus cos x is equal to 0. Now if you see this equation, here also we are having logarithmic function as well as trigonometric function also. So this equation involving both the function, therefore this is also the example of transcendental equation. So your equation should involve either trigonometric or logarithmic or exponential or all three. Okay. For exponential, let us take if you are having x into e to the power of x minus cos x is equal to 0. X into e to the power of x minus cos x is equal to 0. Now if you see this equation, here we are having exponential function as well as trigonometric function. Therefore, this equation is also called transcendental equation. Okay. So this is the difference between algebraic and transcendental equation. Suppose if they ask the Thomas question, they can ask, okay, either define algebraic and transcendental equation and give example. Okay. So write down the definition of algebraic function. Write down any one equation. Write down the definition of transcendental function equation. Write down any one equation. Okay, that is nothing but example. Or they can ask, write down difference between algebraic and transcendental equation. So it is enough if you write the two equations, two differences. Write down first difference is their definition, and second difference is nothing but example. Means answer is same. Either they can ask in this way or they can ask in definition. Okay, so this is nothing but algebraic and transcendental equation. Because we have to find the solution of algebraic and transcendental equation only. Next is root of the equation. Because we have to find in this numerical root of any given algebraic equation or transcendental equation. Root of the equation. Root of the equation. See, you know this, what is meaning of root of the equation, because you studied this basic thing. I think science students studied in PUC level, and for commerce students in the last sem only I have given this. What is the root of equation? You find the root of equation using three methods, either factorization or complete square method, or what is that? Using the formula b minus b plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2. Okay, then you will get the root of any equation. But what is the meaning of root of equation? Suppose if f of x is equal to 0 be any given equation. Okay, here f of x is either algebraic equation or transcendental equation. Okay, f of x is any algebraic or transcendental equation. Suppose if f of x is equal to 0 be any given equation, then c, let us take c be the, or c is the real number. Okay, let us take c is the real number. Then this c is called root of f of x. Then c is called root of f of x if it satisfy f of c is equal to 0. If it satisfy f of c is equal to 0. Means instead of x, if you are substituting the value of c, we want again that overall calculation value should be 0. Okay. For example, let us take x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. This is the given equation. Okay. Or this is f of x. And it is algebraic, because here algebraic quantity in volume. Then here we can call x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3 are the roots of this equation. Why? Because if you substitute 2 here, what we will get? 2 square is 4 minus 5 into 2, you will get it is 10 plus 6. Calculate this. 10, 4 minus 10 is minus 6 plus 6. Minus 6 plus 6 is 0. Then you are getting 0. Therefore, x is equal to 2 is the root of the given equation. Means f of c is equal to 0. After substituting x is equal to the value of c, then we, and if satisfy this equation, then we can call c is the root of f of x. And here the value of c is first is 2. Similarly, try for 3. 3 square is 9. Minus 5 into 3, 15. Plus 6. Calculate this. 9 minus 15 is minus 6 plus 6. Again it is 0. Therefore, we can call 3 is also root of this equation. Okay. And here 2 and 3 are the real numbers. You know what is real numbers. Then, since 2 and 3 are real numbers and it satisfy this equation. What is mean by satisfy means, if you are substituting the value of x is nothing but these two value, and if you are getting this 0, this is equal to RHS side is 0, and if you are getting that value is 0, then we call these two are satisfying this equation. Therefore, these two are the roots of this equation. Here I have written directly, but you know how to find the roots of this equation. See, if you use the factorization method, here we can find x square. We have to split these numbers into sum of two numbers, such that their multiplication is 6, their addition is minus 5. If you consider minus 2 and minus 3, see, minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5, minus 2 into minus 3 is plus 6, and this plus 6 as it is. If you find the roots, what you are getting, x is common, here we remains with x minus 2. Here minus 3 is common, here we remains with x minus 2 is equal to 0. Then again from these two terms, x minus 2 is common. So here we remains with x, here we remains with minus 3. This is equal to 0. So what we will get, x minus 2 is 0 and x minus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3. These are the roots of the equation. This is the method to find the roots of the equation. Okay. So here 2 and 3 are called roots of the equation. That is the definition of root. Or if you want, for the transcendental equation, cos x is equal to 0. Here f of x is cos x. Okay. Then at what value of x you are getting the cos x value is 0, then that value is nothing but root. If you substitute x is equal to pi by 2, then cos pi by 2 is equal to 0. Because pi is 180. 180 by 2 you will get cos 90 degree. And the value of cos 90 degree is 0. So you are getting cos 90 is 0, that is cos pi by 2 is 0. Therefore here pi by 2 is the root of cos x, that is f of x. Okay, so this is the definition of root of the equation. This is the definition of root of the equation. Okay, this is one. Now this is the basic thing, the algebraic equation, definition of transcendental, what is mean by root of the equation. But now we will see the some method to find the root of any given equation. Okay. And these methods are called numerical methods, because using this method, we will find approximate root. You know the meaning of approximate. Since just I have solved x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. And roots of this equation we find x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3. These are the real roots. Okay. And using the factorization method, we find this root. But in the numerical, we will try to find the approximate root of this equation using different method. Approximate means, suppose if x is equal to 2 is the root of this equation, then approximate means you will get nearly this. Either you will get 2.00 some value, or you will get 1.921 some near value. Okay. See, 1.9 means it is nearly is equal to 2 only. So in numerical solution, we will not get exact root, but we will get approximate root of this equation. We will get approximate root of this equation means nearby, near root of the exact root. Okay. So we will see some method. Our first method is bisection method. First method is bisection method, or we can call another name is there, interval halving method. Interval halving method. They can use any one name from these two. Okay, they can ask the example using either bisection method or interval halving method. Okay, now what is, how to solve using bisection method? If f of x is equal to 0 is the given equation. Let us take f of x is equal to 0 is the given equation. Either it is algebraic or transcendental. Then we have to find the root of this equation using bisection method. Okay. So for that, first we have to find an interval AB. We have to find an interval AB such that if you are substituting the value of A in this equation, f of A, and if you are substituting the value of B is also f of B, we want these two values are opposite in sign. These two values are opposite in sign. These two values are opposite in sign. Opposite in sign means we want one should be positive, one should be negative. Either your f of A is positive or your f of B is positive. Okay, one should be positive, one should be negative. suppose if you are getting f of a is positive, greater than 0 means always positive. And suppose if you are having f of b is negative, that is less than 0. Okay, if you are having it, this is positive, this is negative, then we can call these two are opposite in sign. Or you can take f of a is negative and f of b is positive. Okay, either first condition should satisfy or the second condition should satisfy. We want both are opposite in sign. One should be positive, one should be negative. Okay, from these two, any one should be positive, any one should be negative. Then we can call this interval is perfect, a comma b. Okay, but this condition should satisfy. Okay, one should be positive, one should be negative. Or if you are multiplying these two, you will get the value is negative only. Then, we will take, in this case, let us take f of a is greater than 0 and f of b is less than 0. Okay, let us take this is positive and this is negative. Okay, we are getting a and b values such that when we are solving the example, you will get this how to find the value of a and b. Okay, suppose if f of a is positive and f of b is negative, then our first root, let us denote that by c1. Our first root lies between a and b. Then it is given by a plus b divided by 2. This is our first. Okay, a plus b divided by 2. If this condition is satisfied, here f of a is what? Positive. Here f of b is negative. If this condition is satisfied, then our first root is lies between a plus a and b, and it is given by a plus b divided by 2. That is the formula. Now, what is the next step? Find f of c1 now. Okay, whatever the calculation you are getting here, substitute that value again here instead of x. You will get the value of f of c1. Just I have said, suppose if x square plus x plus 1 is the given equation. Okay, and if you are having interval is 1 comma 2, then what is f of 1 you will get by substituting x is equal to 1 in this equation. How you will get f of 2? By substituting 2 in this equation. Okay, suppose if it satisfies this condition, then you will get your first root is 1 plus 2 divided by 2. Okay, then you will get here some answer. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 divided by 2. So, you will get 1.5 something. 1.5 etc. Then we have, this is the value of c1. This is the value of c1. Then again we have to find f of 1.5. How we will find? Again substitute x is equal to 1.5 in this equation, you will get the answer. Okay. So we have to find f of c1. Now, what is the next step? Suppose, this is important. Okay. Suppose if f of c1 is less than 0. Suppose if f of c1 is less than. Less than 0 means it is negative. Less than 0 means it is negative. Okay. If your f of c1 is negative, then in these two steps, check for which value we are getting positive value. For which value we are getting f of x value is positive. Now, if you see, for b, again we are having negative. No, we don't want both should be negative. We want one should be positive, one should be negative. And for c1, your next root is given by c2 is equal to c1 plus. Okay, next root is c2 is equal to always this root, c1 plus. Next, here we are having, it is negative. We want the value for which f of x is positive. Here we are having positive. And it is for which value? A value. Because f of a is positive, after substituting x is equal to a, we are getting this value is positive. Then we will get our next root is c1 plus a divided by 2. C1 plus a divided by 2. Because we want 1 is positive, 1 is negative. Here we are having negative, here we are having positive. We will take a is the next value. So your next root c2 is given by c1 plus a divided by 2. Suppose if this condition fails and you are getting your f of c1 is positive. If you are getting your f of c1 is positive. Okay. Here in this, this is the case when you are getting it is negative. But suppose if it is not negative and f of c1 value is positive, then your next root, that is again c2 only, is lies between c1 plus. Here we are having positive. Check the value at which you are having negative, and it is negative at b. So your next root is lies between b. So c1 plus b divided by 2. c1 plus dv divided by 2. That is the next root. This is the c1. You will get the next root c2. Okay. Suppose if they ask the 5 marks, they can ask up to 5 stages. Suppose if they said find up to 5 stages, we have to find c1, c2, c3, c4, c5 using the same case. Okay. You are getting c2 value here. So, repeat the same thing again. Suppose if your f of c2 is positive now. Okay. Suppose if your f of c2 is positive now. Okay. And f of c1 is negative. Suppose if f of c2 is positive and f of c1 is negative. Then your next root c3 lies between c. This is positive, this is negative. So c2 plus this is positive, this is negative. So we will have to substitute c1 here. c2 plus c1 divided by 2. c2 plus c1 divided by 2. If your f of c2 is positive. Because one should be positive, one should be negative. Now suppose f of c2 is positive. But if this case is true, f of c1 is also positive. Okay. If your f of c2 is positive and f of c1 is also positive. But you will get both are positive. Then the root does not lies between these two. We want one is positive, one is negative. Here we are having f of c2 is positive. Here we are having f of c1 is also positive. Then again go back and again go for these two. Okay. So here for which value we are having negative? We are having at b. It is negative. So again you will get c2 plus b by 2. That is the next root. Repeat this process till we want the answer. Up to c5, then c5. You will get the required answer. Okay. See, explanation is not difficult. But you will come across when we will solve the problems. You will get how to take the roots. Okay. I will explain step by step when you are solving the problems. Okay. And we will see the problems in the next class.